So let us start. The first theorem is write down the inverse of a square matrix A. The inverse of a square matrix A. This is the theorem. The inverse of a square matrix A. Matrix A exists when inverse of a square matrix A exists if and only if A is not singular. If and only if I double F is if and only if A is not singular. Okay. A is non-singular means determinant of A must does not be zero. That means determinants of A does not zero, then only the inverse of a square matrix exists. Okay. So what is the inverse? Actually, you can find next we know that adjoint of A dot adjoint of A is equals to I, and A is the matrix of order n. Okay, so this result we know very well. Okay, now if we divide by determinant of A, we get what you get here. If you divide this result with the determinant of A, then adjoint of A upon determinant of A is and this is nothing but R n. Okay. And if you see, this is nothing but supposed to be this is B. Then that adjoint of A upon determinant of A is equal to B. Then what we have, that AB is equals to BA is equals to I mean that is identity matrix of order. So AB is equal to BA is equal to I, and then you know very well B is nothing but inverse of A. If B is inverse of it, then only this result is possible. So B must be equals to A inverse, and this is nothing but what? Adjoint of A on determinant of A. It's B is equals to this. Now you can say simply B tag A inverse. So A inverse is adjoint of A upon determinant of A. This is the inverse of a matrix. So what is inverse of a matrix? Adjoint of A upon determinant of A. So whenever you need to find the inverse of a matrix, so first you find adjoint of that matrix and divide it by the determinant of A, you will get the what? Inverse of a matrix. So please note it down. Put it down first, then after we'll see next theorem. Okay. Next theorem is invertible matrix possesses. Next theorem is an invertible matrix possesses says unique inverse. That is inverse of a matrix is unique. That is, you can say in other words, inverse of a matrix is unique. This is also given in NCERT. Okay, so inverse kya hota hai matrix ka? Unique hota hai. एनसीईआरटी में बड़ा सिंपल सा प्रूफ है, उसको आप लोग देख लीजिए. ठीक है, हम लोगों को ये रिजल्ट याद होना चाहिए. अंडरस्टूड? नाउ नेक्स्ट थर्ड वन, थ्योरम नंबर थर्ड. इन दिस यू हैव टू राइट दिस मे बी यूनिवर्सल लॉ. यूनिवर्सल लॉ, दिस इज universal law. Also known as universal law. That is, let A and B are two matrices. A and B are two matrices which is invertible of the same order. Here we are two matrices which is invertible and both have same order, then AB whole inverse is nothing but B inverse. A. This is also very important. Okay? B inverse A. Clear? Put it down. This is also known as reversal law, as you already know, study in the transpose of matrices also, that AB transpose equals to B transpose equals A transpose. Clear? Put it down. The transpose of a matrix and invertible matrix is also invertible. The transpose of invertible matrix is also invertible and A transpose inverse is A inverse transpose. This is also important result. A transpose inverse is A inverse transpose. Okay? That means transpose of a matrix, invertible matrix, is also invertible matrix. Okay? Also, next theorem. Next one, this is A. If A is invertible symmetric matrix, then A inverse is also symmetric. If A is invertible symmetric matrix, then A inverse is also symmetric. And say A is symmetric, then A inverse also symmetric. But here it is written A invertible. कोई मैट्रिक जब भी नेगेटिव इनवर्टिबल है इसलिए यहां पहले ही लगा दिया गया. अगर A इनवर्टिबल सिमेट्रिक मैट्रिक्स है A इनवर्स इज आल्सो अ सिमेट्रिक मैट्रिक्स. ओके नेक्स्ट थ्योरम इफ A एंड B दिस इज आल्सो these are the result which we use to solve the question. Okay, theorem if A and B are non-singular matrices of the same order, A and B are non-singular matrix of same order, matrices of same order, matrices of same order, then adjoint AB is nothing but adjoint of then order then, this is also important, adjoint AB is nothing but adjoint A and adjoint B. This is the result. Okay? Similarly, you may study about determinant of AB is nothing but determinant of A into determinant of B. Okay, so note it down. Okay, now next and last, this is also important and many time question asked on this theorem only. Okay, write down if A is an invertible matrix, if A is an invertible matrix. That is non-singular. Invertible means non-singular. If A is an invertible matrix, that is non-singular matrix, then adjoint of A, adjoint of A, determinant of adjoint of A, nothing but determinant of A to the power minus 1. Where n is order of matrix, A is non-singular matrix. A is non-singular matrix. A is non-singular matrix. This is the most important result. Okay? What? A determinant of adjoint of A is nothing but determinant of A to the power n minus 1. बहुत बार ये क्वेश्चन आया हुआ है. ओके, इस पे बेस्ड क्वेश्चन बहुत बार पूछा है, इसलिए इसको आप जरूर समझ लें. सो इन दिस मैनर वी हैड टू सी मेनी ऑफ द थ्योरम व्हिच इज यूजफुल फॉर सॉल्विंग द क्वेश्चंस. ओके, note it down and then after we see next thing. We will do a question based on inverse. So write down, find the inverse of a matrix. Find the inverse of matrix. A is equals to find the matrix. A is equals to 0, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 3, 1, 2. A is equals to 0, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 1. is the inverse matrix. So for finding inverse of this matrix, what is the working rule? You know very well. First of all, we find x right of the matrix, and then divide it by determinant of A, then we will have what inverse of the matrix. And what is the working rule for finding adjoint? We have already told you. First, you find cofactors of A, then form a matrix B. Form a matrix B, which is from cofactors of A. Then take transpose of the matrix B. Then this is nothing but adjoint of A. So in this question, first of all, we find what cofactors. So let us start finding the cofactors. A11 is what? You know, this is the matrix like A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32. So, first of all, you find the determinant of A. Why? Because if determinant of A is not zero, then only we find the inverse. Determinant of. So everyone has to find the determinant of A. Find it. Zero. Leaving this row and this column 2 and 2 minus 3. Minus 1. This row and this column 1 1 1 1 9 plus 2, and this is nothing but leaving this row and this column 1 minus 6. This is 0 because multiply by 0 minus of -8 plus 8, and this is plus of 2 into -5. 8 minus 10, this will be minus 2, and this does not equal to 0. And if the determinant A does not equal to 0, determinant of A does not equal to 0, it means A is non-singular. And non-singular means this matrix is invertible, and we are able to find the inverse. Okay, so put it down. This is the first stage, determinant of A. Cofactors, that is nothing, A11. Cofactor of this. What it is? A11, that is positive. So leaving this row and this column, this row and this column, 2 under 2 minus 3. Okay, 2 minus 3, this is minus 1, A12, A, otherwise you write A21, leaving this row and this column, we will have 1 minus 2, and here, this is A21, this is odd number 2 plus 1, that's why I already limited. So 1 minus 2 minus 1, so this is plus 1. Ultimately, this is plus 1. So in the same manner, you have to find all cofactors, okay? So A11, A12, A13. Similarly, A21, A11 is minus 1, A21 is 1, A21 is minus 1. A21, this is what? A31. A12. my A11, A12, A13, +2, A21, A22, A31, A32. So you can find it. मैंने आपको बता दिया कैसे निकालना है, हम यहाँ पे लिखने जा रहे हैं, उसको देख लीजिएगा. ओके, तो A11 is -1, A12 is 8, 1 का आ रहा है 8, A13 is -5, A21 this is 1, A22 this is -6, A23 is 3 only, and A31 is -1, A32 is +8, 3, 2. What is 8, 3, 3? This is -1. So what we will get here? We will get all the cofactors of a matrix A. Now, suppose to be B is the matrix. B is the matrix formed by cofactors of A. Cofactors of A. So this is nothing but अब यहाँ पे सिंपली आपको A11, A12 ये सब रखना है. तो -1, 8, -5, 1, -6, +3, -1. So this is the matrix B formed by the cofactors of A. Now, what is the adjoint of A? Now, adjoint A is B transpose. And B transpose means interchanging row by column, -1, 8, -5 in row. -1, 8, -5, 1, -6, 3, 1, -6, 3, and -1, -1. This is the adjoint of A. This particular matrix is adjoint of A. Okay, we understood. The adjoint of A is nothing but -1, -1 by row. हम आपको row में बोल रहे हैं 8, -6, 2, yes, -5, 3, -1. Okay. Now, what is inverse? Inverse is nothing but adjoint of B. Inverse is nothing but adjoint of A dividing by determinant of A. A inverse is nothing but adjoint of A upon determinant of A. This is adjoint of A -1, 1, -1, 8, -6, 2, -5, 3, -1, and this is divided by 1/-2. -1/2 से आप पूरे मैट्रिक्स में मल्टीप्लाई कर दीजिए और यही इनवर्स होगा. और आप हमने डिटरमिनेंट मैट्रिक्स में बोला था कि इनवर्स निकालने का हम आपको तरीका बताएंगे और वो यही तरीका है इनवर्स निकालने का. ठीक है, बाय रो कॉलम ऑपरेशन आप करेंगे प्रॉब्लम होगी, लेकिन इस तरीके से आपको इजिली आ जाएगा. एंड एग्जाम में कभी भी ऐसा नहीं आप पूछा जाता, जनरली आपको सिंपली क्या बोला है, इनवर्स ऑफ द मैट्रिक्स. सपोज करिए रो कॉलम ऑपरेशन से पूछ भी दे, तो ये मैं आपको इंटरनली बता रहा हूँ, आप किसी भी मेथड से कर देंगे नहीं पूरा, तो कुछ ना कुछ मार्क्स को मिलना है. ओके, आ रहा है सबको समझ में? बेटा सुनाई दे रहा है?
यस सर।
किया
यस।